Hello guys, let's discuss this problem. This problem says the daily minimum temperature in degrees Celsius which is recorded in a certain Arctic region are as follows. These temperatures are -12.5, -10.8, -18.6, and that's how it will go on for all the other observations. Using these observations, you need to represent them as a frequency distribution table, taking -19.9 to -15 as the first class interval. When you know the class interval, then you can easily write the data in frequency distribution table. But when you don't know, then it is pretty tough. As I have already taken a problem before in which there was a class size wasn't the class interval. You needed to find out the class interval yourself. So now let's represent the data. Here, this table. In this table, our first column is for class interval of temperature, temperature recorded in these intervals, and the frequency related to those intervals. So for the first interval, which was asked to taken as -19.9 to -15. Here, in this range, there is only this one temperature which is falling under this interval, which is -18.6, and that's why the frequency is 1 for this interval. For this interval, which is minus 15 to -10.1, make sure here the interval is class size is 4.9, and you need to keep the class size same for all the other intervals. So that's why I have taken another interval from -15. Then what you have done, you have added 4.9 in it to get the interval, to get the upper limit as -10.1. So here all these values are falling under this interval, and how many observations are there? There are exactly 8 observations. So that's how you are going to do the same thing for all the other intervals, and you'll get the frequency. And you know that number of observations will give you the sum of these frequency, which is 8, 1, 9, 5, 14, 14, 7, 21, 21 and 14 will give you 35. So here the frequency is 35, which means number of observations we have given in an experiment is 35. So this is the representation of the data in a frequency distribution table. I'll be taking more problems in the coming video lectures. Thank you.